Santa Cruz Warriors coach Aaron Miles watches Kevon Looney as he takes a shot during Golden State's warm-ups before Game 5 of the NBA Western Conference semifinals against New Orleans at Oracle Arena in Oakland on May 8. Miles worked as an assistant coach for Golden State during the playoff run. Doug Duran, Bay Area News Group. When the cigars came out and the champagne spray soaked every centimeter of the visitors' locker room at Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland, Santa Cruz Warriors coach Aaron Miles was there with his goggles on. Miles had the opportunity to tag along on several legs of the Golden State Warriors' run through the NBA playoffs. That include being on stage Friday when the Warriors hoisted Larry O'Brien Trophy after sweeping the Cleveland Cavaliers and in the locker room to celebrate afterward. In many ways, the experience was like a Warriors fantasy camp for Miles, who spent all 6 months of his NBA playing career before it was cut short by injury with Golden State. Coach got to sit in on meetings alongside Golden State head coach Steve Kerr and assistant Mike Brown, among others, and was encouraged to speak up with suggestions. He worked with players on developing skills and even got a chance to take the court against the likes of Finals MVP Kevin Durant and Stephen Curry as part of the scout squad. For the record, he filled in for the Spurs' DeJounte Murray and the Pelicans' Rajon Rondo. "It was a very humbling and unbelievable experience for myself," Miles said in a phone interview Monday. "For Steve Kerr and Bob Myers to open their arms and let me be involved in the way they did, I felt it was a tremendous opportunity, but it wasn't all just games and fun for Miles." He and Santa Cruz Warriors general manager Kent Lackob were invited along to soak up the experience with the expectation they would not only be valuable contributors, but that they also would bring much of what they learned back to their G League team. From a Santa Cruz perspective, "There's a lot of value we can take and apply to how we want to run our operation down there," said Lackob, who took over as GM in 2016. "It was a tremendous growing experience, a tremendous opportunity to learn and grow from it." Miles, fresh off his first season coaching in Santa Cruz, said he constantly made voice memos and jotted down notes about tips and tricks he picked up on the playoff trail. He talked about the value of a minutes chart in keeping players fresh and about scripting the timing of plays. Both Miles and Lackob, however, said they were most impressed by how deeply the mantra, strength and numbers, permeated every aspect of team operations. Kerr implemented the mantra when he took over as Golden State's coach in 2015 and promptly led the club to its first NBA championship in 40 years. "It is why Durant took a $10 million pay cut last season so the Warriors could retain veterans Andre Iguodala and Sean Livingston, and why Klay Thompson said he will take a discount to be able to stay with the team when his contract expires in 2019. It was, most likely, part of the reason Miles and Lackob got to be a part of the playoff run and will be riding in Tuesday's championship parade through Oakland. In addition, Lackob said he witnessed it firsthand in observing how veteran center Zaza Pachulia handled his diminished playing time during the playoffs. While his court time was reduced, Lackob said, Pachulia's role on the team was not, instead of saying, "I should be playing," he took the opportunity to hold other players accountable and make them better. Lackob said, "That's what we mean when we refer to the culture. You see it from player 1 to player 15. But that culture is really something that's hard to develop. We hope we can take some of that and try to apply it." Both he and Miles realize that won't be easy, especially considering the constrictions of playing in the G League, where rosters are constantly in flux and getting players NBA call-ups is tantamount to, or perhaps even trumps, winning championships. Miles said he believes it starts with establishing a strength in numbers culture in the front office. "It starts with our staff members holding each other accountable. Then it trickles down to the players," Miles said. "It's obtainable." At the same time, Lackob said, they have to realize they can't simply duplicate what Golden State is doing and expect it to work. "It's not going to be the exact same fabric and culture as the Golden State Warriors because every team is different," he said. We don't want to replicate that. We want to find our own culture that will match what we're facing in the G League. Because of their connection with the parent team, the Santa Cruz Warriors have a head start on weaving that strength in numbers attitude into the team culture. Lacob exhibited a little of it himself in speaking of his favorite part of the champagne-coated locker room celebration. He said he noticed Quinn Cook, a player who had been in the home locker room at Quicken Loans Arena many times while on the Cavs training camp roster in 2016, sitting down in the midst of the raucous celebration, taking it all in. Cook bounced around the NBA and the G League for 2 years after being cut by Cleveland before the regular season. That fall, he fell in with the Warriors, who signed him to a two-way contract to play for the parent club as well as in Santa Cruz. But when Curry went down with an injury late in the season, Cook stepped up and shortly after received a contract through the 2019 season that also placed him on the Warriors' playoff roster. With the champagne and trophy and all this stuff going on and all this excitement for everyone, the most special part for me of this entire weekend was when I saw Quinn really soaking in what happened, when it sunk in that we had won, Lacob said. The fact that I got to experience Quinn winning a championship is far more valuable than any championship I could have won, just because of the type of person he is. Contact Julie Zhang at 831-706-3257.